assist in lowering insulin. Why? Because when you consume all this sugar, you're actually dumping all your B vitamins and potassium out to the urine up to 15 times more than if you didn't have this problem. So you're losing all this. And don't worry, consuming nutritional yeast won't give you a yeast infection. All right, and the last thing I want to recommend would be protein. Because protein is a nutrient and it's blocked from the cell, you're probably going to be deficient in protein. So you need to have protein, especially for breakfast. Okay, that's very important. Because if you don't, then at the end of the day, your blood sugars are going to be so far off that you're going to need the need for insulin and medication is going to be much, much greater.
Okay, let's quit this video. I will straight away pick up, okay. First, right, you say potassium. How you get this? 7 to 10 cups of vegetables. Or you can get these tools right from my shop. I'll show you how to get it. So you see, what is it doing first? First, right, scare you, okay. Scare that is, you need potassium, 7 to 10 cups of vegetables, you know, 7 to 10 cups. But never mind, not shortcut. Okay, so what is it? That's very clear. And this guy is actually a medical doctor. And there are plenty of medical doctors up there, right, which are doing these kind of things. Next, right, he talks about the B1 nutritional yeast, which is also in his shop. And lastly, right, this whole approach of selling nutrient by nutrient to prevent disease, right, is a dangerous approach because, right, we all know for very long, right, mainstream science community that individual supplementations of nutrients, right, never solve any health problem, one. Okay. Next, right, the EV part. Here, right, he at least give some elaboration. But protein, you just need to get lots of it. Because if you don't miss your, if you miss your protein, your blood sugar will go up. What's the link? See, it is simply right brushing it off. No explanation, and just telling you a conclusion. And hopefully, right, that you will remember these three conclusions and just act upon just these three conclusions. This is a very dangerous video, okay? All the more because it came from a medical doctor. So now medical doctor also very hard to believe, really, okay? Last video.
But there's a second way we can end up with high blood sugar. What if there's enough insulin, but the insulin doesn't work? The key is there, but something's gummed up the lock. This is called insulin resistance. Our muscle cells become resistant to the effect of insulin.
This whole thing is the muscle
What's
cell.
What's gumming up the door locks in our muscle cells preventing insulin from letting sugar in? Fat. What's called intramyocellular lipid. Fat inside our muscle cells. Fat in the bloodstream can build up inside the muscle cell, creating toxic fatty breakdown products and free radicals that block the signaling pathway process. So no matter how much insulin we have out in our blood, it's not able to open the glucose gates and blood sugar levels build up in the blood. This mechanism by which fat induces insulin resistance wasn't known until fancy MRI techniques were developed to see what was happening inside people's muscles as fat was infused into their bloodstream. That's how we found out that elevation of fat levels in the blood causes insulin resistance by the inhibition of glucose transport into the muscle.
Okay, in the last video, I'm trying to portray to you that this one is the more credible one. But you see, this is a video, right, that critiques papers, right, papers from scientific journals and look up their findings, what is the conclusion, and it presents to you mechanism. Okay, that one may not be true, I'm telling you, you need to be critical. Okay, and all these things, right, they are peer reviewed, so if they are not true eventually, right, someone else will go and take them down, each other, okay, scientists will fight a war with each other. But the thing is, right, it is open, it's transparent. I tell you the mechanism, I didn't just cover it up, okay, and just give you a quick fix, tell you that, oh, get this thing from my e-shop, okay, so on. Anyway, this is, I'll show you more videos from here. This is so difficult for everyone to be watching because who will want to watch this kind of things, okay? It's easier to get compulsions, right? Give me a promise, 30 days, okay, I persevere, 30 days I'll do it for you. After that, like, I hope that I see something. So you see, a lot of these things, right, information or interpretation is a lot about our human psychology, okay? So I hope after you woke up today, right, you can forget the next two-thirds of the presentation. Those are not important anymore because those are just facts available somewhere else. It is the ability to think, to predict, that is most valuable. So after today, right, if you have this with you already, you can look at individual situations and make good sense from them. Okay. Some things that our minds are prone to do, this is interesting, I actually enjoy reading it. The whole list is like 40 plus 50 tendencies or policies of the mind. All these are biased, strange ways that our mind work that prevent us from being very rational and logical. Confirmation bias, we already have a perception, a belief, and then we try to find evidence to support us, and then we say, correct, that affirms what I believe all along, okay? Conservatism, I have my belief, I refuse to be adjusted, even though there are new information coming in, I don't want to update, okay? Dunning-Kruger effect, okay? Skilled people think that they are not so good. Unskilled people overestimate their own ability when I'm referring to knowledge, okay? We think that we know a lot, okay? So this is dangerous. Insensitivity to sample size, we did not realize, right, that when the sample size is small, down to one, which is anecdotal, okay, you hear someone, hey, I need this thing, right, okay, then I suddenly feel or what, okay. And if you believe these kind of things very readily, right, you see, that is our insensitivity to sample size. It's only one, okay, it's either word or the word, what else? Okay, so you when you want to hear conclusions, right, you want credible conclusions based on bigger sample. Irrational escalation, people justify things, right, that they have already put in investment. For this matter, belief is one. Okay, we already believe something, we invested a lot of time in it, we have believed it all our life. Now you want me to take myself out of this belief, difficult. Neglect of probability, like what I say, a lot of medical research, right, are all giving you numbers, statistics, okay? They are supposed to point a way to likelihood. So you should just understand it as such, okay? If the likelihood of the risk is high, should I still do it? It should influence the decision in a rational way. Reactants, the urge to do opposite of what people ask you to do. This one is very obvious, okay? When you're about to shower that time, then your mother say, how come still haven't shower? Hurry up and shower lah. Then you feel very irritated. Later lah. Then you do work. You're about to shower already. Or you're about to eat. Or you want to do something. The moment your mother say, you feel, then you don't want to do it anymore. You see, this is human nature. So I hope I didn't stir these reactions by my message. Wise man proportion is believed to the evidence by David Hume, British philosopher. Although I gave you a starting slide by telling you that by evolution, we are not very adapted to scientific thinking, right? But by evolution, we will eventually be able to do it as well, okay? It's an adaptation. So, I hope that today this session, right, will serve to fulfill this. Let's start the main part of the thing, the factual parts. Energy system and macronutrients. Let's look at all the questions that you sent me. Essentially, right, I think you got the questions pretty appropriate. It's all about like the macronutrients and energy systems. So I hope, give me some time to read through. I hope after the talk, right, I have addressed most of them already. Okay. Recommended simple breakfast before training. What to do in spite of intermittent fasting being a trend? Role of carbohydrate to gaining weight. noodles or rice, which kind, is rice bad or choice, protein, how much, is there any such thing as too much, how to carb load, okay, what should I eat if I'm not supposed to eat sugar? Actually, you could, you know, if you are chewing on a sugar cane and you are biting, at the same time, right, chewing off fibers and so on, right, I think that sugar is probably okay if you are an animal that feeds on sugar cane. But if you're the human, right, that only takes the end product, the sugar, and eat it, right, without all the fiber and everything else, that's where the danger comes. Okay, what do our body needs? We need macronutrients. What do macronutrients mean? Okay, macronutrients are your carbs, protein, fats. They are substrates, right, which can produce energy. So you need to understand this main difference between macronutrient and micronutrient. And macro, right, because you need it in huge amounts. Okay, and how huge is like orders of thousands to one, okay, or tens of thousands to one, is an order of magnitude. Okay. Fundamentally, right, when we ingest all these things in, they are broken down by our body. They eventually will become some chemicals. Okay. Protein will become amino acids. Carbohydrates will become glucose or fructose, saccharides. Okay. Fats will just become fatty acids. Fiber is usually not put in this list, right, of nutrients our body need, because fiber, right, actually don't get absorbed at all. Fiber is something that just pass through. But passing through things in our body is important because, right, it starts off from being useful, ends up as being toxic. Okay, you don't want it to turn toxic and still stay in your body too long. Okay, you want to pass it out. Let me just ask you, if someone, right, goes to the toilet and bowel movement every day of the big one, is this person suffering from constipation every day? Who think yes? Who think no? Every day shit, yes. Who think maybe? Answer? Maybe. Everyday shit doesn't mean that you don't have constipation. Constipation is things get stuck in there very long. So it can mean that the thing that you are shitting out today came from last Monday, came from Christmas. Alright? Then tomorrow's shit came from Boxing Day. Understand? So what's the transit time? 7 days. 7 days is constipation already. So it's just first in, first out, the same logic, okay, but it is long time the old goods, okay. You need really, right, to ensure that this bowel movement is 24 to 48 hours type. How to achieve that? You need to eat a lot of fibers. Otherwise, right, you will start eating shit, unfortunately, okay. Because, right, the shit, when it is inside your body, right, what will happen? Toxins will get reabsorbed back, okay? And there is a condition called leaky gut syndrome, okay? And leaky gut syndrome is triggered by animal protein, mainly milk. And it makes your gut, the cell walls, right, in the intestinal lining, permeable. So toxins, right, start to flow opposite direction, back into bloodstream, and you become toxic, okay, and you fall sick. That is a disease, okay? But many of us could have variable degree of this thing already happening if your bowel movement is not very smooth, okay? So I don't think anyone wants to eat shit, but unfortunately, we unconsciously do so. Okay, what is micronutrients thing in much smaller quantity? This you need to understand. Canoeists are actually a very well-educated group of people already. I think most of you have some knowledge coming into this talk. But we mostly are very obsessed with 1, 2, 3, okay, these three things only, because it seems that, especially this thing, it seems that that's what this is made out of, okay? But these things are actually much more important because you forget, besides this, right, you have your heart, liver, kidney, all the organs, okay? Your brain, all the parts, their inner functioning. These are things that you can't see in your mirror, okay? How do you know they are in a good state? This one, every day, you spend time, right, or walk around in the mirror, or I think a lot of people go topless, okay? Because if you're proud that you have good machines, okay? Good, the big gun there, okay? And you want to show it. But you see, what we really need to be concerned about, right, is the things inside. Are they working well? How do you pay attention to feeding these processors? And then you should also evaluate, right, in the past year how many times you fall sick. The number of times you fall sick, right, is an indication of your inner well-being already. Okay, you can be very fit, right, on the outside. That's because you train, number one, and number two, right, you are young, so your body is still in a growing stage. So you give it stimulation, right, the training, it will over adapt and become stronger, bigger. But inside, right, there's no positive stimulation. It's toxic, and it will just become malfunctional. More about carbs. Well, carbohydrates are main biological source, right? It's a source of energy. Okay, all living things, down from human to the bacteria. Okay, we all run on glucose. Carbohydrate in Chinese is called 碳水化合物. Tan, carbon, 水, water, H2O. Carbon, H2O, the compound that comprises carbon and water. So you see the general formula is always this, C6NH12NO6N. Minimum is 6, okay? 6 is the what we call the monosaccharide, mono, 1. 3 monosaccharide, fructose, glucose, galactose, okay? They come together to form the disaccharides also, biochemistry. Sucrose, right, table sugar, what you add in most food, okay, is first two. Lactose is glucose plus galactose. Maltose is glucose plus glucose.